In this video, we will be looking at relative atomic mass and relative molecular or formula mass. Relative atomic mass, or AR, is found on the periodic table. Work backwards when defining relative atomic mass. Mass. This is the average mass. Atomic actually means of the isotopes of an element. Relative, compared to 1/12th of the mass of a carbon-12 atom. Relative molecular mass and relative formula mass are both written as MR, but there is a subtle difference. Relative molecular mass is the total mass of a molecule. Relative formula mass is the total mass of an ionic compound. The questions that you are usually asked about relative atomic mass are different to those about relative molecular or formula mass. The way to calculate relative molecular or formula mass is to add up all of the relative atomic masses of the elements in the chemical. We will use three compounds to show the process. Step 1 is to determine the number of each atom in the compound. CHO contains one carbon, one hydrogen, and one oxygen. CuCl2 contains one copper and two chlorine atoms, because the small 2 belongs to the element before. BeNO3 twice contains one beryllium, two nitrogens, because the small 2 belongs to everything inside the bracket, and six oxygens. Three oxygens inside the bracket, which is then doubled because of the small 2 after the bracket. We then look up the relative atomic masses on the periodic table and apply them. So, CHO is 12 plus 1 plus 16. CuCl2 is 63.5 plus 2 times 35.5. BeNO3 twice is 9 plus 2 times 14 plus 6 times 16. Once you have the calculation, you can work out the MR. CHO is 29. CuCl2 is 134.5. BeNO3 twice is 133. Take your time with compounds that contain small numbers and brackets. NiSO₄ contains one nickel atom, one sulfur atom, and four oxygen atoms. Remember, the small number belongs to the element before. This means that the answer, as shown, contains one nickel atom. It also contains one sulfur atom and four oxygen atoms. From the periodic table, nickel has a relative atomic mass of 59, as shown in the answer. Sulfur has a relative atomic mass of 32, and oxygen has a relative atomic mass of 16. These values can now be filled into the table. In the question, nickel is given as an example, 1 times 59. So, sulfur contributes a total mass of 1 times 32, or 32. And oxygen contributes a total mass of 4 times 16, or 64. The total mass of NiSO₄ is therefore 59 plus 32 plus 4 times 16, which equals 155 for 2 marks. If you did not get a final answer of 155, you can still gain 1 mark for either the sulfur row being correct or the oxygen row being correct. In the second question, XCl2 contains one atom of X and two atoms of chlorine. Again, remember that the little number 2 belongs to the elements before it. From the periodic table, chlorine atoms have a mass of 35.5. So X is 95 minus 2 times 35.5, which gives an answer of 24. The element with a mass of 24 on the periodic table is magnesium. This answer gains 1 mark. Be careful, because a very common mistake in these questions is to use the atomic number on the periodic table instead of the mass number. You should be able to define relative atomic mass as the average mass of the isotopes of an element compared to 1/12th of the mass of an atom of carbon-12. Relative formula mass is the total mass of a molecule. If you are dealing with an ionic compound specifically, then it should be called relative formula mass. To calculate relative molecular mass, you add up the relative atomic masses of all the atoms in the molecule or ionic compound. Take care when the chemical formula contains subscript numbers and brackets. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.